Shifting focus to other news, a French prime minister has, for the first time, conceded that mistakes had been made dealing with the Yellow Vest protest. The prime minister acknowledged that the government dealt with the situation badly from its start and was now trying to lend a better ear to the fellow Yellow Vest protesters' claims. The PM said he was open to one of the Yellow Vest protesters' newest demands, which is passing a law enabling the citizens and not the president to call for a referendum and change existing legislation. But the outline and the timeline of this debate are still unclear, as it is planned to start in the next 3 months with no clear agenda yet.
Ce fut d'abord la colère contre une taxe, et le Premier ministre a apporté une réponse en annulant et en supprimant toutes les augmentations prévues pour le début d'année prochaine.
As the Prime Minister stated, Edouard Philippe stated as of today, this morning in the French press, the crisis has been very badly dealt with. I mean, it was really, it took three interventions on the part of the President, French President Emmanuel Macron, just to gain a little calmer situation, just in order to make it more quiet.
Now, so far, 8 people have died as a result of the protest on France's roads by the Yellow Vest protesters, which have gone on for over a month now. The Yellow Vest movement started in mid-November with the protest at junctions and roundabouts against fuel tax increases, but quickly became a wider mobilization against Macron's economic policies.
Nous avons commencé dès la semaine dernière, des ronds-points ont été évacués, nous allons poursuivre cela. Vous savez, samedi, il y a eu une 8e personne qui est morte. C'était à Avignon, un jeune homme, gilet jaune de 23 ans. C'était la veille, une jeune femme de 25 ans qui a été victime d'un accident arrivant sur un rond-point occupé, mais non signalé, et donc elle a perdu la vie. 8 morts. Est-ce que vous connaissez un autre contentieux social sur ces 30 dernières années qui a tué autant de personnes? Donc je le dis clairement, ça suffit. Ça suffit pour la sécurité des gilets jaunes eux-mêmes. Ça suffit pour la sécurité de nos concitoyens. Ça suffit aussi pour la sécurité de nos forces de l'ordre.